You definitely stink. Where you been? You're too cute to be from hell. You practice sorcery? Okay. What are you even doing? No, that wasn't what we were looking for. Maybe I just didn't have my mind in the right place. Maybe go somewhere dark. Somewhere deep in the past. Somewhere ancient. Somewhere less farty. The secret of witchcraft is that it is not what we think it is. When you hear the word witchcraft, do you imagine 40 old women scudding through the sky on broomsticks to a rendezvous with the devil? Then think again. Witches have been men as well as women, beautiful as well as ugly, and have worshipped other gods as well as the devil. They have lived in all ages, in all cultures. This book uncovers the truth behind the stereotype that is the secret history. These ideas have been completely transformed into a religion of equality and respect. It still has the power to unsettle the bravest among us. Let's find out what's isn't necessarily anything of supernatural origin. So incidentally, modern witches reject the suggestion of satanic associations on the understandable grounds that Satan, or the devil, is a Christian concept. Association between sex and lust, probably the more instant gratification of those two aspects of human nature, which are often regarded as an aspect of the devil's characteristic. So interesting that they are tapping into nature and not
show you guys the art. This book was filled with really, really profound
so true that women, of course, lack the physical stature of men for the most part, but in that small area that they lacked power, I believe they make up for it more than enough in the sheer effect. Their lives to protect and worship women at the house. They are equally, in return, giving the women so much power over themselves, able to demolish their sense of identity and ego. If the women so choose, associated with animals known as the heavenly cow, probably for how fertile and nutritious cows can be in both milk and meat. Oh, it also includes a lion, as we can see here. Over here, shows a worshiper praying, paying homage to Ishtar, who is seated on a griffin, a creature which was half eagle and half lion. Oh, sorry, up here. And then here, the ancient gods were often invoked as protection against evil spirits. This was a boundary stone. Ishtar, the sun god Shamash, and the Sin, and Sin, the moon god. So here the goddess. The goddess Isis. Powerful and revered gods of the ancient world. was a great magician or sorceress who tricked the sun god Ra into giving her immortality. Very, very poignant. Depiction of the female's ability to wield a power over men. Is the associated with the dog star Sirius. One of her symbols is the moon, and her name means seat or throne. Then here, the image of the Virgin Mary with the infant Jesus bears resemblance with her Horus, who was conceived by magical means. So here we have the Witch of Endor from the Old Testament book of Samuel. Known depiction of a witch from the Bible, though she would be more accurately depicted as a prophetess or a female prophet. Very interesting picture. Not sure what she's looking. Society people such as mystics and necromancers were regarded with some mistrust. Yet one of the greatest magicians of all time was himself the king of Israel, Solomon, son of David, the very David that defeated Goliath. Solomon's wisdom is well known, especially in the famous story of how he ruled a custody dispute that the child concerned should be cut in half and thus produced a reaction from the real mother. And that wisdom was, according to the Hebrew Bible, a gift to Solomon. Was able to command demons and carry out its construction. very knowledgeable about ancient histories and myths. So here, King Solomon was painted here at the bottom by 17th century. Western culture. setting. So it's at dusk.